Yeah, Guru, I've muted everybody. You have to unmute yourself and start. Yeah, I can see the screen.
Good evening, everybody. I welcome you all for this virtual meeting today of our group. And today's topic of this meeting is going to be Tripurantaka, the beautiful form of Shiva, the concept, the form, and the art. What we see Tripurantaka as concept and the art form, and what we see in the temples of our representations of Tripurantaka. I once again welcome you all for this virtual meeting. Tripurantaka is that form of Shiva that burnt the three asuras, Tarakaksha, Kamalaksha, and Vidyutmali, who are orbiting this world with their three forts made of gold, silver, and iron. These three asuras were orbiting in their own forts and troubling everybody in this world. So these three great demons were the one who were samhara of these three great demons were done by Shiva. And that form of Shiva who did the samhara is known as Tripurantaka. Shiva is the victor of the three asuras. And because he won over the three asuras, he gets the name Tripurantaka. Three people were killed. So the three Antakas. So Tripurantaka. He is also known as Tripura Samharamurti, Tripura Sundaramurti, Purari, Tripura Vijaya, and so on with many other names also. Tripurantaka Shiva, the form of Tripurantaka Shiva is praised in Satarudriyam of the Yajurveda. What you see here is the sculpture of the 11 Rudras seated in a row from the temple of Kanchipuram, Kailashnatha temple of Kanchipuram. Tripurantaka is one among the 11 Rudras who are known as the Ekadasha Rudras. The Satarudriyam says Tripurantaka, praises Tripurantaka as one among the 11 Rudras in this particular sloka, which goes like, Namaste astu Bhagavan Vishveshwaraya Mahadevaya Triyambakaya Tripurantakaya Trikalagni Kalaya Kalagni Rudraya Neelakantaya Mrityunjayaya Sarveshwaraya Sadashivaya Sriman Mahadevaya Napaham. The 11 names of the Rudras are appearing here in this sloka, and Tripurantaka is one of that. So Tripurantaka is one of the 11 Rudras as praised in the Satarudriyam of the Yajurveda. Yete heter bismaha haste bhavata bhavaha tate dhanuhu Tayasman Vishwata Mayakshmaya Paripruja is one of the verses of the Rudra. There it says, you are the one who showers the blessings with our weapon, with your weapon of bow and arrow in your hand. And you are there to completely protect us from the evil. That's what this above sloka means. Namaste Ishmadhyo Dhanubhyascha Vo Nama. Again, the same Rudraigam, there's another sloka which mentions about Shiva holding the Dhanus. Salutations to you, the one who bears the arrows and also carries the bow in your hand. To you, my salutations, O Lord Shiva. This is the meaning of this above thing. So, Tripurantaka form of Shiva holding the bow and arrow is praised right from the Vedic periods of with the chant of the Rudra. Shatarudriyam, in the Namaka portion, praises Shiva in many verses. Rudra, as the one who holds the bow and arrow in his hands, he is seen as the protector of this world. Shivarudra, who is seen with the bow and arrow, is also known as Pinakapani. Shiva is known as Pinakapani. The word Pinakapani is very common in the northern part of India. Shiva is referred there as Pinakapani. Taittiriya Samhita of the Yajurvedas, Vajrasayini Samhita, narrates the story of Tribhuvanantaka. To win over the Asuras, the Devas performed a yajna. The three Asuras were disturbing the Devas to a very great extent, and all the Devas joined together and they performed a big yajna to save them from the cruelty of these three Asuras. That yajna which they performed was called as Upasat. From that yajna of Upasat, there emerged an astra, a beautiful astra to kill these demons. The Devas did not know how to use this astra against those Asuras. They were very confused. So when that confusion was there, the first thing they did is they went to Rudra. They approached Shiva, Rudra, to help them. Rudra says, if the Devas, all of them together, elect him as the leader and accept his supremacy, only then he will use this weapon against the Asuras. See, the Rudra, why he says that? So because only the chief or the head has the right to punish. Not every sundry person can do this. The punishment can be given only by the head. So that's the meaning behind this. Rudra says, the Devas are all Pasus who have surrendered. Let them come and surrender to their Pati, who is Shiva. And when they all come and surrender to Shiva as their Pati, Shiva is known as Pashupati. Accepting Rudra as the Pashupati, when they accept, all the Devas accept Shiva as their Pashupati, they take up the ash from the Vedic sacrifice, the upasat that they created, they made. So they apply it on their forehead and they start doing the Shivalinga worship. So thereby all of the Devas become Shiva devotees. Then Rudra says, this is the time. I will sit down to destroy the three Asuras, Tarakaksha, Kamalaksha, and Vidyutmali. The three Asuras, Shiva says that he is ready to go and fight against them, or rather destroy them. These three Asuras had created three forts, a fort made of gold, a fort made of silver, and again another fort made of iron. They were orbiting around the space at different levels. And they were orbiting in a particular speed all over this, covering the entire earth. And every point of place, they were troubling the Devas, shooting arrows at them and troubling them. So this was a continuous torture for the Devas to go through. The Asuras had taken a boon from Brahma, who is their ancestral grandfather. They said they could be killed only when the three forts which are orbiting this earth in different directions come in a single line. When they all come in a single line and with one arrow, somebody has to shoot them out, which was an impossible task, all the calculations that you could make. That sort of a constellation of the three forts coming together can happen only once in a million years or so. So it was a very Herculean task for them to take over and kill these Asuras. So Shiva sets out to kill these asuras. Vishwakarma, the Devatacha, makes a beautiful chariot for Shiva to travel with Prithvi, the mud. The sun and the moon become the two wheels of this beautiful chariot. Mount Meru, the huge Mount Meru, becomes the bow for Shiva. Vasuki, the serpent, becomes the thread to tie this bow, string to tie this bow. Brahma takes the position of the charioteer, and the four Vedas become the four horses for this chariot of Shiva. And Shiva sets out in this beautiful chariot. This is the chariot in which Shiva is seated from the temple of Madurai, Meenakshi Amman temple, Sundareswara Swami Sannidhi. There's a beautiful representation of Triprantaka standing on the chariot. Vishnu becomes the arrow. Agni becomes the barb. Agni, that is again a big energy, becomes the barb, the sharp point of the arrow. Soma takes the stem of the arrow. Yama becomes the rear feathers of the arrow. All the devas join the army of Shiva. They all sit down, set out, and move around to kill these asuras. Along with Shiva, they are all out to kill the asuras. This is again the Triprantaka in Pudumandapam in Madurai. The fiery Shiva, with the twisted eyebrows, red bulging eyes, shoots the arrow at the Tripurasuras and burn them out along with their forts. This is the way in which Shiva destroyed the three Asuras. Shiva, the destroyer of the three Asuras in their three forts, get the name as Tripurantaka or Tripura Samharamurti. So this is the Tripura Samharamurti. Shiva gets the name as Triprantaka and Tripura Samhara just because he conquered the three asuras and destroyed the three forts. In our Tamil country, there's a slight twist to this episode of Triprantaka, which we are going to see now. The three asuras were Shiva Bhaktas. According to the Purana here, the three Bhaktas, all these three asuras were also Shiva Bhaktas. They did this Linga Puja, Shivalinga Puja every day. And when the devas had approached Shiva to destroy them, Shiva said he cannot do so to destroy them because they are all his devotees. All the three asuras are his devotees. So Vishnu says, all the devas decide that they have to break the Shiva Puja of this asura. So they all approach Vishnu. Vishnu takes the form of a Buddha and disturbs the mind of asura, and thereby they give the Shivalinga worship. The Buddha here is not the Gautama Buddha. Buddha is a mention of any avatar or any person going against the principles of the existing religion. So somebody has to mute it. I request you to kindly mute it. So this way, when Vishnu takes the avatar of Buddha, he disturbs the mind of the three asuras. They give up the Shivalinga worship, and thereby Shiva is ready now to attack them. This is explained in a Tamil text, a lot of Tamil texts, and it's also seen here in the sculptural representation from the big temple of Brihadishwara at Tanjavu, where all the three asuras are here and Buddha is here, Vishnu as Buddha is here, disturbing the mind, and the original bhaktas disappear there. Shiva bhaktas disappear and the asuras take the form. So now it is the time ready for Shiva, who sets out to destroy the asuras. All the Shivagadas Devatas, all joined the army of Shiva and they set out to destroy these three asuras after they were changed the faith and became the Buddha, followers of Buddha. So the Devas and Ganas, when they all set out, they all had a thought in their mind. That's because of their strength, because they are in thousands of numbers, because of their strength, Shiva is going to destroy these asuras. And this can happen because of their support. Shiva is going to accomplish this. That sort of a thought was there in all the Ganas and the Devatas. This is a beautiful sculpture from the Dharasuram temple. Shiva gets onto the chariot. The moment he gets onto the chariot, the axle of the chariot breaks, which brings in a disappointment to everybody. Vishnu immediately takes the form of a bull and supports the chariot from below. So when Vishnu does that, chariot is stabilized. So it comes to a standard, a regular position. So that particular Rishabha, which supports the chariot of Shiva, Vishnu in the form of that Rishabha, is known as Malvidai. In Tamil country, we say there are two Vidais. That is, the general Nandikeshwara is called as Dharma Vidai, and this particular Rishabha is known as Malvidai. Shiva, standing on this chariot, sees the three asuras. They all come in a line right in front of Shiva's eyes. Shiva sees them and gives them a smile. Immediately, the three forts are burnt to ashes and the three asuras are destroyed and blessed by Shiva. Shiva, because they were Shiva Bhaktas once upon a time, Shiva blesses him, blesses all the three asuras. The two asuras who are blessed become the Dwarapalakas of Shiva by name Chandi and Mundi, and they guard the entrance of the Shiva temple everywhere. The third asura by name Bana becomes again an asura by name Bana, and he starts playing the Panchamukha Vadyam, which is known as Kudamulla in Tamil, for the Shiva's dance. Wherever Shiva is dancing, you find this Banasura playing the Panchamukha Vadyam. Banasura was a great, great devotee of Shiva. So he is considered as the prime devotee of Shiva. Even today, when we offer worship to Shiva, after offering all the worship to Shiva, we always pray to the devotees of Shiva to bless us and give the puja pala. There's a sloka which goes, Bhana Ravana Chandisha Nandi Bringi Ridhadara Mahadeva Prasadena Sarve Anugrahanta Shambhava. So you pray to Bhana, Nandi, Bringi, Ridhadara, all these people, Ravana, everybody, who are all great devotees of Shiva, to bless and give us the Shiva Prasada. So this great importance is given to the three asuras who were destroyed by Shiva. They were blessed by Shiva here. This is a beautiful sculpture of Shiva as Triprantaka from the cave temple of Pandian cave temple of Vilingiyam in Kanyakumari district. So beautiful Shiva standing there as Triprantaka in the facade of the cave. The Sangam period work of Purnanuru and Silapadigaram, Kalitogai, etc., speak in chaste Tamil poetry, the episode of Triprasamhara and Shiva as Triprantaka. Shiva performed the dance of Kodukatti on top of the chariot seat after winning over the asuras. Parvati, by the name Bharati, she joins Shiva and she also dances along with Shiva. And that particular dance of Shiva and Parvati is known as Pandarangam. This Pandarangam and Kodukatti are explained in detail in the Tamil texts of Purnanuru, Silapadigaram, Kalitogai, and so many other works of Tamil Sangam period poetries. Shiva's dance after the Triprasamhara The dance that Shiva did after Tripura Samhara is known as Tripura Tandava. This Tripura Tandava is one among the Sapta Tandavas of Shiva, which Shiva performed as Nrityamurti. Shiva as Nrityamurti performed 7 Tandavas, and this Tripura Tandava, which he performed after the victory over the Asuras on top of the chariot that he traveled, is known as Tripura Tandava. Now let's come to the concept of Tripurantaka. The Vedic concept of Tripurantaka, Tripura Samhara, is Shiva is the one who helps to fight over the Maya. The killing of Asuras is equated to that of Mayas that are around us, and Shiva, the destroyer of the Maya. So Tripurantaka is the destroyer of the Maya. He is the one who helps us to come out of the 3 stages of life. Jagrat, that is the active stage in life, Swapna, the dream stage, and Sushupti, the deep sleep stage. Whatever is there in the mind, he helps us to come out of this, and that is the form of Shiva, is Tripurantaka. Shiva's bow, in which he kills the Maya, is used for killing the Maya and bringing out the knowledge of light within us. So the Maya, once it has been removed from us, the knowledge completely comes into us, and that is what is the Tripura Samhara, the inner meaning of Tripura Samhara. The Vedas call this Tripura Samhara Murti as Pashupati. A sect of Saivism in those days, which was known as Pashupata, says that we all, human beings, are Pasus who are surrendering ourselves to Pati, the Lord, who burns the Maya or the passion in us. The same is repeated in our Saiva Siddhantic works also. Shiva is the Pasupati. Tripurantaka, form of Shiva, is worshipped by the Pashupata sect people as the supreme god, as their Pashupati. Shaiva Siddhanta also talks about the same in the same line. The bow of Shiva that he carries burns the 3 malams that we have, Anavam, Kanmam, and Mai, what we call in Tamil. So he is the one who burns the 3 Kanmams of Mayas of us, and that is Pashupati Shiva as Tripura Samhara. Tirumular, a great author of Saiva Siddhantam and also an Ayanmar, who wrote 33,000 verses spread over 3,000 years, and that verse is called Tirumandiram. In that Tirumandiram, he says, Appunai Senjadai Adi Purandanan, Muppuram Chetanan Enbergal Moodargal, Muppuram Avadu Mummalakariyam, Appuram Eidamai Yar Arivaru. Appunai Senchade, the one with the matted locks, red matted locks, who's the Adi Purusha, the Adi Puranan. Muppuram Chetanan Enbargal Moodargal. He is the one who destroyed the 3 Asuras in the world. That's the people who do not understand that. That Muppuram, what he burned, is that of our 3 karmas. Anavam, Kanmam, Maya. But all these things were burnt, are there to be burnt by Shiva. So that particular secret of how he burns out the 3 malams in us is not being understood by everybody, is what Tirumular says in this wonderful Tirumandiram. Tripurantaka Shiva is one of the 25 Maheshwara Rupams of Shiva. Tripurantaka forms the part of the Tatpurusha face of Shiva, and that face of Tatpurusha shines like that of a gold. Hello, can I request you to please mute? I don't want you to talk in between. Hello? May I request you to mute?
Vaccination.
Who is that disturbing here?
The medication. The medication.
Hello.
Mr. Gopinath, please. Mr. Gopinath, please mute your phone. Mr. Gopinath. Gopinath, phone, please mute it.
No, I don't want to have a disturbance like this. Please kindly mute it. Shiva is also, this Tripurantaka form of Shiva is also one of the Ashtashta Murti, that 64 forms of Shiva is worshipped, and that 64 forms of Shiva is known as Ashtashta Murti. So this Shiva is one of the Ashtashta Murti. Tripurantaka is said to be a Raudra Murti because he did the Samhara. Raudra Murti is seen with crooked eyebrows, angry, red, bulging eyes. And he is a Samhara Murti, the person who's doing the Samhara in anger. But in sculptures and bronze images of Tripurantaka, you see this Tripurantaka representation as more as a Karunya Murti, the man who's got a lot of compassion in him. The face is seen with full of serene compassion. So he's always depicted as a compassionate Murti. Let us explore the form of Tripurantaka as described in the Saiva Agamas. Amsabheda Agama describes about 8 forms of Tripurantaka. There's hardly any major difference between these 8 forms. The general description of this form of Shiva is seen common in all the Agamas. It says the right leg of Shiva should be kept in front and firmly fixed. The left leg should be slightly bent and placed behind. One of the right hands should be shown in Simhakarana. That's the Simhakarana pose. At the height of the Nabhi Sutra, at the navel level, he should hold this right hand. And the left hand should, and that right hand which is holding in Simhakarana should be as though he is pulling out a string from the bow with the arrow set inside. Look at that. That is the Simhakarana. It clearly represents that he is pulling the string of the bow and the arrow is set in that. Very beautiful description and how he holds that beautiful hand there. The thickness of the arrow that Shiva is aiming should not be more than the size of the little finger of Shiva. This is what has been explained there in that agama. What are the left hands? He should be clasping the bow and raised in a horizontal position, and the thickness of the bow should be exactly fitting inside the fist of Shiva. Says how he holds the bow. Look at that beautiful way in which he holds the bow. And the hand in which he holds the bow should be at the shoulder level. Not above that or not below that. It should be held at the shoulder level. And that's what you see in this wonderful bronze of Tripurantaka here. The remaining 2 upper hands, one should be in Katri Hasta, holding a tanka, that is the battle axe, which is called as Maru in Tamil. He holds one of the battle axe in one hand, and in the other hand, he holds a Krishna Mriga, the black antelope. This is the way in which he holds in the other hand. Unfortunately, in this idol, that the head of the antelope is broken. But you can see the antelope there. And apart from this, Uma should be always there accompanying Shiva. Whenever Triprantaka's form is represented, there should be Uma by his side. This is what the Agama says. The Uttarakamika Agama says that Shiva should be shown with three eyes. And the right ear should have the Makara Kundalam and the left have to be plain or as Patra Kundalam. As you see here, the three eyes of Shiva. This is the right ear. You find the lobe alone there. The Makara Kundalam in gold is normally placed in these Utsavamurtis. And the left lobe, ear lobe, is seen with the patra. That is, the patra is folded leaf, palm leaf. That's what is called as patra kundala. Shiva can be represented with two or four hands carrying the bow and arrow. It's a must for all this form of Triprantaka. The body of Shiva should be standing in Samabhanga attitude. And the next four forms of Triprantaka are dealt with minor differences and variations, and the details of the position of the legs and hands keep changing there. In this position, it says the left leg of Shiva should be placed on top of the Apasmara Purusha. Shiva should always be represented with four arms, and this is what is one of the Agamas talk about the fifth form of Shiva. The sixth form of Shiva is shown with Shiva with multiple hands, eight arms, holding Bana, Pashu, Khadga, Vajra on the right side, and left hand he holds the Dhanusu, Ketaka, Vishmaya Mudra, and Kataka Mudras. All this is what is the description. And that particular description suits this image of the Hoysala Sura temple panel of Shiva. The dancing Shiva, it could be, I assume it to be Triprantaka form of Shiva, which closely resembles to this particular description. The body of Shiva should be in Ashtabhanga. Again, this is also in a lot of Bhangas are there, which adds grace to this beautiful form of Shiva. And Uma has to be always by the left of Shiva. This is what this Agama says about the sixth form of Shiva. The seventh form of Shiva states, Shiva is to be represented with 10 arms. And that I could not find a figure. Here what you see is the beautiful representation of Shiva as Triprasambhara Murti from the temple of Vidyashankara at Sringeri, built by Bukharaya. The three forts are seen one above the other in one line, and Shiva is shooting the arrow to kill these three asuras. Parvati is there and Brahma is also seen on this chariot. Again, it describes about the different weapons that Shiva has to carry in different arms. That's the slightly difference between the seventh and the eighth form of Shiva, which has been explained in these Agamas as Triprantaka. The eighth form of Shiva is again a beautiful form which is represented that Shiva should be shown always on top of the chariot. This is the beautiful sculpture from the Ellora Kailasha cave, where Shiva is seen as Triprantaka seated on the chariot and aiming the arrows at the asuras. The horses are seen on the side. It's actually a turning wall which is in the right angle. The beautiful way in which they've used this for creating the sculpture is amazing. On one corner, Shiva is seen as Triprantaka on top of the chariot, and the other wall, which is intercepting, is shown with the horses that are in flying. The right leg should be raised and be shown as if it is resting on top of the chariot, and the left leg should be planted in the middle of the chariot. Mukula portion of the chariot should be tied to the chariot, and the Brahma should be shown as the charioteer seated on top of the mukula. Brahma should be shown with holding the kamandala and kundika in his upper arms and two hands holding the bamboo stick to control the horses, and Padmapasha, the noose, to control the horses. The chariot of Shiva, in which he is represented as Tripurantaka, should always be shown as if it is flying in the air. So this is the description of the eighth form of Tripurantaka as per our Agamic Shastras. Then come to the temples of Tripurantaka. In Tamil Nadu, Tiruvadigai is one of the Ashtavirattanam temples of Shiva, where Shiva did the Tripura Samhara here. Tiruvadigai is close to Panruti, and this is the Tripura Samhara Murti of the on the beautiful Vimana of the Tiruvadigai temple. As this place, Shiva has done the Tripura Samhara, I told you earlier. Shiva's Utsava Murti is very beautiful as Tripura Samhara Murti, and he is worshipped at the Samhara Murti of this place. The Moolasthanam of this temple is Shiva, who is known as Virakteshwara, but still he is also known as Tripurantakeshwara. And that Moolasthanam is 16-faced rooted linga. And the Samhara Murti or the Utsava Murti is Tripura Samhara Murti, seen with this concert Tripura Sundari. Another temple for where Shiva is worshipped as Tripurantaka is known as Trivirkolam. This is again a Padalpetra Stalam, now known as Kuvam, and which is very close to Chennai. This Trivirkolam temple, Shiva is sanctified as a linga in the sanctum, and he is worshipped as Trivirkolanada or Tripurantakeshwara. It is said the color of the linga keeps changing based on the climate. During hot seasons, the Shivalinga is red in color, and during winter seasons, it's almost white in color. And this beautiful Shivalinga is a Tinda Tirumeni Nadar, where people, where the priests also cannot touch the Shivalinga. They do the Abhishekams just like that, pouring the water on Shivalinga. They do not use a cloth or anything to wipe the Shivalinga. Apart from that, this god inside is known as Tripurantakeshwara. There's no sculptural representation of Tripurantaka or in the bronze form worshipped in the temple. So this is one temple of Tiruvirkolam dedicated to Tripurantakeshwara. This 10th century temple of Kalyani Chalukyas is known as Tripurantakeshwara temple in Belagavi in Shimoga district of Karnataka. This is a very beautiful architectural temple with exquisite sculptures and carvings of the Kalyani Chalukya period. You can see the beautiful carvings there. Apart from the name of this temple being as Tripurantakeshwara, the sanctified lingam inside the sanctum is called by this name. There's no representation of Tripurantaka in any sculptural or bronze forms in this temple. The earliest cultural representation of Tripurantaka in South India is seen on the outer wall of the Swarga Brahma temple at Alampur, which was built by the Badami Chalukyas. This is the Swarga Brahma temple, and you see this image of Tripurantaka there. This temple was built by Badami Chalukya King Vinayaditya in 681 CE, which is 25 years earlier to that of the Rajasimha temple of Kailashnatha built at Kanchipuram. So this is a structural temple that came much earlier than the Kailashnatha temple. And here you find the beautiful representation of Tripurantaka, the first ever representation of Tripurantaka. A lovely sculpture of Tripurantaka is seen from Aiholi, now housed at the National Gallery in New Delhi. This is a beautiful sculpture of Shiva shown as Tripurantaka from Aiholi. The three forts are seen here, and Shiva is seen shooting the arrow at the three forts. Brahma is seen as the charioteer, and Shiva is standing on top of the chariot and he shooting the arrow. This is a beautiful representation of the Badami Chalukyas at Ayoli. At the same time, the Pallavas also started the temple building activity in Kanchipuram, and you have similar representations in that Kailashnatha temple. Here Shiva is on the chariot, aiming the arrow and shooting at the three asuras. And Brahma is seen as the charioteer. Tripurantaka, again, this is a freestanding sculpture now housed in the Badami Museum of the Western Chalukyas of the Badami. Here, Tripurantaka is shown standing on the chariot with eight arms, aiming an arrow at the asuras, represented by the four different forts from the D sides. Here, the beauty of this is that Brahma is seen as the charioteer, and the interesting picture is that Parvati is also seen here in the chariot, seated along with Shiva. She's seated when Tripura Samhara is being done by Shiva. The first ever representation of Tripurantaka, form of Shiva, in our Tamil country is seen in the shore temple of Mahabalipuram. Mahabalipuram, beautiful shore temple, everybody would have visited it and seen it. It's one of the most wonderful temples built by Rajasimha Pallava at Mahabalipuram, the seaport of the Pallavas. In this temple, you have this representation of Tripurantaka as you see here. This representation of Tripurantaka is not seen on the walls of the temple, but it's located on the compound of the temple. Very beautiful representation of Tripurantaka on the compound, where you see the row of Nandis seated on bodhis. This is a beautiful representation of the earliest representation of Tripurantaka as seen in our Tamil country. The Kailashnatha temple at Kanchipuram, built by Rajasimha Pallava, has given a great importance to this form of Shiva, in seen in the sculptural representation of Tripurantaka is seen at many places in this temple. From the Kailashnatha temple. In the outer shrines of the temple, you have 53 outer shrines, and this particular Shiva form of Tripurantaka is seen there in almost about six places. Tripurantaka representation is given in six places in this particular temple. The Kailashnatha temple at Kanchipuram is very unique. Around the sanctum, you have seven beautiful sub-shrines dedicated to different forms of Shiva. In that way, the northwest sub-shrine of this particular temple is dedicated to Tripurantaka form of Shiva, and he seems seen there standing on top of the chariot with eight arms, flanked by so many devas on either side of him. This is a beautiful representation of Tripurantaka in the Kailashnatha temple of Kanchipuram. Look at that. This is a wonderful panel. Again, the representation of Shiva as Tripurantaka in the Kailashnatha temple of Kanchipuram. Shiva is seen standing on the chariot with Brahma as the charioteer. And you see, one side you have Bhadrakali, and the other side you have Durga Devi, who have joined Shiva in the mission to destroy the Tripurasuras. That we saw that earlier. So Bhadrakali and Durga Devi are seen by the sides of Shiva, who joined the Shiva in the mission to destroy the three asuras. Look at this wonderful sculpture. Closely observe that. Tripurantaka is shown almost standing on the chariot with one leg folded, kept on top of the chariot. He's shown standing with his left leg bent and placed on top of the chariot. Shiva is seen with a smiling face that conveys, that smile on Shiva's face conveys that samhara is completed. When he spied that particular second, the samhara happened. So that is the frozen moment when the samhara was completed. Brahma is seen as the charioteer. Now, why we say this action of completion of the samhara has happened is seen with Brahma's action. Brahma is seen clapping the hands. So when Shiva destroyed the three forts, Brahma was happy. He left the reins of the chariot and started clapping. So that very clearly depicts that samhara happened. Everything happened. The Shiva smiled, samhara happened, immediately the Brahma clapped. All this happened in fraction of second. So that particular fraction of second is frozen in this beautiful sculpture. So when the samhara is finished, all the bhutaganas which accompanied Shiva started to dance in joy. And that's what is represented here. How, what a beautiful representation of this particular movement of Tripura Samhara. So beautifully enjoyed by Sapati and brought out into life in this particular sculpture. What an amazing representation of Shiva as Tripurantaka in this Kailashnatha temple. Marvelous sculpture. Now we come to the bronze image of Tripurantaka. The metal images of Tripurantaka's form started with Pallavas and saw a great boom during the prime of Cholas. The Chola kings and the queens started concentrating these images in many of the temples they had built, and special festivals were conducted for this worship of Tripurantaka. Starting from 9th century to 12th century, many such images were installed in the temples, along with the images of Somaskanda and Nataraja. The images of Tripurantaka was particularly taken around in the chariot during the annual festivals. Now today, Somaskanda is seen being taken around the chariot around the Mada streets of the temple. Earlier days, it was Tripurantaka who was taken in the chariot to denote the victory of the three asuras. So Tripurantaka form was the one which was taken around the chariot in those days in all the temples. Tripurantaka worship had a direct impact. Why this particular aspect of Tripurantaka is worshipped so much in Tamil country has got a direct impact to the Chola history, and let's explore that. Vijayalaya Chola started this Chola Empire in 850 CE, and he was followed by his son Aditya from 891 to 907. Aditya is the one who expanded the great Chola Empire, which was started by Vijayalaya, and Parantaka, the son of Aditya, 907 to 950, consolidated the great empire that was a great warrior like Aditya fought and brought in, and he was, this Parantaka consolidated it, but in later years, he had a great setback. Parantaka had a great setback when his son, the crown prince known as Rajaditya, was killed in the Thakolam battle against the Rashtrakuta king, King Krishnathri, in 949. The 30 odd years after the death of Rajaditya was very uncertain period for the Cholas. They saw five different rulers. They had lost many territories, and Cholas were confined to a small state. It was a very unfortunate period for the Cholas at the time. Gandharaditya, the brother of Rajaditya, who succeeded Rajaditya as the king of Cholas, was more interested in religion, and he was a great Shivabhakta. He composed many hymns on Nataraja of Chidambaram. In the later years of his life, he married the queen Chembiyan Mahadevi from Marwadi, and she was a great devotee of Shiva, and both of them were involved in Shivabhakta. And they had a son, Gandharaditya had a son at a very late age of his life, and that son was known as Uttama Chola. It was quite unfortunate. This great Gandharaditya, who was a devotee of Shiva, in later years, took to Jainism and deserted the entire family and left into the forest. The third son of Parantaka, who was Arinjaya, was brought in and made the king of the Chola, and he also did not last long. He was a very weak king. Aranyaya's son, Parantakattu, known as Sundara Chola, was made the king later. Sundara Chola, also a great warrior, he consolidated and was holding on to his particular kingdom very well. Sundara Chola was helped by his great son, Aditya Karigala. This Aditya Karigala consolidated the power of the Cholas, fought and got back the Tondai Mandalam and the Pandya kings, and the Cholas regained the power. Unfortunately, Aditya II, that is Aditya Karigala, was assassinated in 969 CE under mysterious circumstances. This followed by a weak rule of Uttama Chola for the next 15 years till Rajaraja came to power in 985. It was during this weak period of Uttama Chola and later in the beginning of the Rajaraja's period, which saw the renovations of the temples from the brick structure to permanent structures were done by the great queen Chembiyan Mahadevi. Tripurantaka bronze images were made and installed in all the temples. Very special worship to this form of Shiva was arranged by the kings just to bring back the spirit to fight and conquer among the Chola warriors and others. This Tripurantaka worship was initiated. A special worship was arranged in all the temples to boost the lost morale of the Chola warriors and the people to regain the last glory of Cholas, and which they succeeded with Rajaraja. Now, what you see here is a beautiful bronze image of Tripurantaka. This is a Pallava period bronze, which was once under worship at the temple of Kulappadu. Look at this beautiful bronze of Pallava period, belonging to 8th century, the first half of 8th century. What a beautiful bronze. This Tripurantaka is seen with four arms, standing with one leg on the Apasmara's head. The front two arms are shown holding the bow and arrow. The rear two arms are also seen holding the arrows instead of the antelope and the Krishnamraga normally seen in the images of Tripurantaka. All the three arms are holding arrows, and one hand holding the bow. This is a very, very unusual representation of Tripurantaka, which is not spoken in any of the agamic texts. This wonderful image or bronze image of Tripurantaka was in that temple of Kulappadu. Now it's been taken to safe custody under the government of Tamil Nadu, and it has not seen the light of this world for almost about 50 years plus. We do not know whether this image is there, but this is one of the rare photographs which was shared to me by Professor Dr. Nagaswamy, my guru, and I am really thankful for him to share this wonderful image of the Kulappadu beautiful Tripurantaka. This is again a very beautiful early period, Chola and Pallava transition period of 875. Bronze of Tripurantaka. This is the most elegant two-armed Tripurantaka from the temple of Thandan Thottam. Now, this is at present in the Norton Simon Foundation of the United States of America, and it is there being exhibited there. And I don't want to go much into this particular thing. And this is again a beautiful Tripurantaka, the two-armed Tripurantaka holding the bow with his left hand and pulling the string to shoot the arrow very clearly. This is a beautiful bronze, again from the transition period of Chola and Pallava of 9th century. Look at that, the rear posture of Tripurantaka. A very elegant pose of Shiva in Sabha Bhanga, with all the weight in one right leg alone. Entire weight of this body torso is there on the right leg. Left leg is just placed like that. The heavy waistband, the loops that are extending on the sash, on the either sides, are very typical distinctive features of the Pallava period. The serene face with the Patra Kundala on the right ear and the Jita Mukutam with the Dadura flower and the crescent moon. The crescent moon and the Dadura flower, that is what you call as Umattampu in Tamil. Look at the beautiful hairstyle, the Shira Chakra, and the beautiful matted hairlocks of Shiva flowing beautifully on the shoulder. What a beautiful image of Shiva. What a beautiful masterpiece creation. A simple necklace, ornaments and heavy geopavitam on the chest band. Everything is seen, which is very typical of the Pallava features. The waistband is seen with beautiful makara clasp and loops that are seen hanging below. A wonderful bronze of this Triprantaka is now housed at the Gautam Sharabhai Museum, Calico Museum at Ahmedabad. It's in the private collection of this museum. This is again a beautiful Triprantaka of the early Chola of 10th century in the temple of Kodumudi belonging to the Chembiyan Mahadevi period of bronze. This majestic Triprantaka stands elegantly in Samabhanga with four arms, and Uma is seen there to the left of Shiva. She's seen standing delicately with one hand, arm on her mate's head, which is again a beautiful representation of this bronze form of early Chola. This is the most wonderful image installed by the great queen Chembiyan Mahadevi in the temple of Thirunallam. This outstanding specimen of her style of school, with sharp features and delicate torso. She calls him as Tripura Vijaya, the one who won over the three folds, and not as the Samhara Murti, the Tripura Samhara. This is one of the most outstanding bronzes among the collection of the Triprantaka bronzes in this temple. The bronze was specially made by Queen Chembiyan Mahadevi and concentrated in this temple to gain the strength of the Chola power under her son Uttama Chola. This is considered as one of the best among the Triprantaka images in this country. This majestic Shiva with very beautiful and delicate Uma by his side is very beautiful. Unfortunately, today, this bronze is considered as jinx one and really not treated well in this temple of Koneri Rajapuram. He's just put to one corner of that place where there is kept in dark. When inquired, and there's never been an Abhishekam or change of Vastram or anything for this particular god for a long time. When we inquired why it was happening like that, it says the priest, they say, whenever this Triprantaka is brought out and we do some special pujas, there is something bad happening in the village. So the village is considered this particular image as jinx one and they don't want to be worshipped. So they've just dumped this beautiful image to one corner of that place where they have the collection of bronzes. Very, very sad to see this. The chandan that is kept on the forehead of this Triprantaka is there for years. So thick, they have not even removed it. Such is the bad condition of this beautiful Triprantaka, one of the best representations of Triprantaka in bronze forms in our temple today. Again, this is a Triprantaka from the Chola period of 10th century, which is housed in the Cleveland Museum of United States of America. Look at the Astraprantaka, a very delicate Tribhanga pose of Shiva and Parvati also. The extraordinary beautiful decorations of the Jatamukuta and the Bakra Kundalas that he wears on his ears, the necklaces, the arm jewelry, everything in this makes this bronze a very unique one. Look at the Tribhanga, a beautiful Tribhanga. The idol was identified earlier as Chandrasekhara by the great scholar Stella Kamrish, and later it was again re-identified back as Tripurantaka. The early Chola image of Tripurantaka in the Field Museum of Smithsonian is what you see here. What a beautiful representation of Tripurantaka. Look at him. Look at him in different angles. How beautifully and elegantly he stands there. Look at the elegance and the grace in the standing posture of this Tripurantaka. The proud moment of Tripurantaka doing the Tripurasamhara. Again, one more beautiful image of Tripurantaka with seen with two arms, which is a Chola bronze of 970 CE, standing with two arms, holding bow and arrow. The headdress of this is treated beautifully and very elaborately. The jewels, the waistband, the buckle clasp, everything is so ornamental, and this makes it very unique bronze of Tripurantaka. The finely modeled, well-proportioned image is a great masterpiece now in the National Gallery at New Delhi. The tall, slender Tribhanga standing of Tripurantaka on seen on the lotus pedestal. See the small triangular loincloth around his waist. The ornamentations of Tripurantaka is very, very simple. The Upavita is short. The Jatamukuta is seen with the crescent moon. It's interesting to note that the antelope and the battle axe are interchanged in the hands. Normally, it's the other way around. The left holds the Briga and the right holds the axe Tanka. Here it is interchanged. I don't know whether it was deliberately changed or for some aspects or reason this should have been done. I do not know what it is, but this is the only Tripurantaka you can find these two things being interchanged in their hands. This is an early Chola 950 bronze, now housed in the Thanjavur Art Gallery. Look at this Tripurantaka. The great strength of this Tripurantaka is manifested in the modeling of the legs of this Tripurantaka. Legs are sturdy. One leg firmly placed on the ground and the second one crushing the demon, Apaspara Purusha, under his left foot. The tall Jatamukuta, the Makara clasp on that, with the crescent moon, snake, and Durdura flower, seem very beautiful in this. Shiva is clad with a loin cloth that falls like a triangle in front. The thick waistband and the Upavita are also seen here, beautifully decorating this bronze. This bronze dated to 875 from the Pallava period. It is from a place called Ponvilaindan Patti, which is close to Thanjavur, now housed in the Thanjavur Art Gallery. This particular bronze was stolen from this temple and was taken for sale. That particular fellow who took this in a gunny bag could not hold the weight, so he dropped it and it fell down. Immediately the sound that it created brought awareness among the people and it was confiscated. So that was the beauty of this beautiful bronze of Tripurantaka. The early period of Chembiyanma Devi, this bronze belongs to 975 CE from the temple of Mayavaram. A very slender torso with rounded face delicately designed jatamukuta and all the ornamentations. Look at the way the hand mudras are perfect and are beautifully depicted in this wonderful sculpture. Tripurantika bronze, this bronze is known as Tanjai Azhagar. This wonderful, elegant bronze was made by Queen of Rajaraja by name Panchavan Mahadevi in 1010 CE. The beauty of this image made her to name this Tripurantika as Tanjai Azhagar. This is one among the 60 odd bronzes that was concentrated in the temple of Brahadeshwara at Tanjavur during the time of Rajaraja. And this is one of the bronzes that has survived, apart from the Nataraja bronze of Rajaraja, which is still under the worship in the temple. Today, this bronze is housed in the Tanjavur Art Gallery. Tripurantika and Kirata. Now we saw this beautiful Norton Simon Tripurantika with two arms. Look at the way he stands there. Similarly, see this. This is the Tripurantika there. And similarly, see this. This is the image of Shiva as Kirata. What a beautiful, you hardly see any difference between these representations of Shiva as Kirata and Tripurantika. This image of Shiva as Kirata Murti is from the Tiruvetkalam temple close to Chidambaram, situated in the Annamalai Nagar. How we can assimilate this as Kirata Murti is only by the help of the supporting images and the inscriptions of the temple. So here, there is a supporting image of Arjuna standing in Anjali Hasta. Shiva fought with Arjuna to give his Pashupata Astram to Arjuna. So that form of Shiva when he came to fight Arjuna is known as Kirata Murti. And the supporting image and the inscriptions of this temple as Tiruvetkalam, the place where the war happened, Tiruvetkalam, this is where the hunting place happened. So this makes it clear that this is not Tripurantika, but this is Kirata Murti. Look at this Kirata Murti, a bronze image from the Avanashi temple very close to Coimbatore. This Kirata Murti can be clearly identified because his hairstyle is so different. It's tied up like a bun and more rustic in his appearance. And this is a clear depiction of Kirata Murti. Now see this three images. If you go through the books, you go through the any of the papers that have been represented in many places, a lot of these images are used, and some of them say it is Tripurantika, some of them say it is Vinadhara Dakshinamurti. So whether it is Vinadhara Dakshinamurti or it is Tripurantika, and what are the reasons that which they claim so, is what we're going to see now. Look at the hand position. The left hand seen holding the bow. So this portion is held like this. So it is called, they say he is playing the veena. Whereas this arm, if the position is like this, they say it is holding the bow. Similarly, this differences is made just by looking at the hand gestures alone. Now, look at the other arm. Here he is seen very clearly holding the string of the bow. Here, the arm is shown as if he is playing the strings of the veena. So they say this position, because of this position, it is Veenadhara Dakshinamurti. Is there a Veenadhara? Absolutely no Veenadhara Dakshinamurti in bronze form is available in the country according to the inscriptions and many other accords which are available here. Veenadhara form of Shiva as Dakshinamurti is seen in the sculptural representations in the koshtas of the temples and also on the vimanas of the temple at many places. But there is no record available that a Veenadhara Dakshinamurti was made in bronze and installed in the temple till today. Veenadhara Murti of Shiva is also available in bronze, but it is not pertaining to be compared with Tribhuvanathaka, but this is a Bhikshadana Murti of Shiva who comes into the Tarakavanam again playing the Veena to give the knowledge to the rishis. First he comes as a Nagna to this Tarakavana rishis. They do the Abhichara against him. Again, he comes back to playing the Samagana in his Veena, and he walks through the Tarakavanam and gives the knowledge to these rishis there. That is what the senior. You cannot differentiate between Veenadhara and Tribhuvanathaka. Whenever somebody says, kindly ignore it and think that there is only Tribhuvanathaka representation and Veenadhara bronze is entirely different as what you see here. Because the Utsav Murtis, which are taken out in precision, are only installed in temple. Tripurantaka is one such murti which is taken out in precision. There's never an idol for Veenadhara Dakshinamurti to be taken out on the precision. Veenadhara special images is seen in very few temples, and one here you see is from the Melapirumbalam temple. Look at the gesture of the hands. Very clearly indicates that he is playing the Veena here. These forms of Bhikshadana showing Shiva as playing Veenadhara is called as Vattanai Nadanda Nadar in Appar, by Appar in his Devaram. The sculpture on the north prakar of the Kantarya Mahadeva temple in Khajuraho, this is a representation of Tripurantaka. This is a 10th century creation of the Chandelas. The North India Hall had followed a different sect of Saivism from the Saiva Siddhantam of the Tamil Nadu. They had followed a Bhairava cult and they had named this form of Shiva as Tripura Bhairava and the Devi as Tripura Bhairavi. The bearded face of Shiva with seen with Bhutas and Vetalas by his foot clearly says that this is Bhairava cult of worship. The 10th century sandstone culture of Chandelas from Khajuraho, now in the California Museum. Look at the beautiful form of Shiva. Look at the Bhetalas, Bhutas all around him. This is again a Tripura Bhairava. The bow is broken and the arrow is not there. This is again a Tripura Bhairava from the 10th century from one of the North Indian temples. Again in one of the museums abroad. This is the Tripurantaka in the Devakoshta of the Tirukkattalai temple in Pudukkottai. The forearm Tripurantaka is seen holding the bow arrow and the bow is held close to his chest. As you see here, the rear arms are holding the axe and the antelope. It's a very, very unimpressive presentation of Tripurantaka of the early Chola period. Now look at this. This is a beautiful Tripurantaka from the Vimana of the Kodumbalur Mover Koil. The posture of Shiva is shown is an action of the vibrant movement seen here. A lot of people call it as Tripura Samhara dance or Tripura Tandava. This could be representing the Tandava of Shiva or burning of the Tripurasuras. Let us see it closely. Look at the close look of the face of Shiva. shows anger in the face, eyebrows are twisted, the eyes are bulging out, red in anger. And there's a sarcastic smile on his face. The lips are open, the two canine teeth are protruding out. The patra kundalas are seen on both the ears, which denotes it as a samhara murti. Looking at the torso of this, the face and the back are almost in similar line. Look at this. The face and back are almost in the similar line, which shows the action there. The right leg is firmly fixed, the left leg is raised to support the twist of the body, which was an action, an action. The left arm is clinching to the bow and then close to his chest, and the right arm behind is pulling out the arrow from this holder. The swift action of this is supported by the flowing cloth around the waist. Look at the cloth flowing around the waist on all sides. Can you say these attributes that we saw in this picture and conclude the scripture as Bundi representing the vibrant action of Shiva sighting the three asuras and suddenly turning around, pulling out the arrow and shooting them at them or smiling at them and pulling down these three forts? What a beautiful representation of Shiva as Tripura Samhara. And this is not the Tripura Tandava as claimed in some of the books. It's only a Tripura Samhara Murti. This freestanding sculpture of Triprantaka and Tripura Sundari that from the dilapidated temple of Govarkoil of Kodumbalu, now housed in the Chennai Museum. These beautiful images were from the time of the Irukkuvels of 9th century, who were subordinates of the contemporaries and subordinates of the Kricholas, early Cholas. This is again a Triprantaka and the Vimana Koshta of the Tirupullabangai temple of 9th century built by Aditya Chola. This depiction is of this image is very similar to that of what we saw in Tirukattalai and Movarkoil, but more refined in the presentation of this. Look at the beauty. He's seen standing with two arms and good features with a smile on his face. He's holding the bow above his head and the arrow is held down below as if he's holding a sword. What a beautiful representation of Triprantaka in Pullamangai temple. This is Triprantaka scene standing there holding the bow from the temple of Tiruvalisvaram in Pandya country. This is the only greatness of this particular temple of Tiruvalisvaram is that the sculptures of Tiruvalisvaram are beautiful. And this is one temple built by Rajaraja outside his Chola territory in the Pandya country, in the middle of the Pandya country. This is again from the Triprantaka representation in that one small sculpture on the Vimana of the Tiruvalisvaram temple. Is this a Triprantaka? How can we say this is Triprantaka? He's seen there standing with one leg on top of the bull, with the bow and arrow ready to shoot. This is the close-up of the image. His one leg is on the ground and the right leg is placed on the top of the bull's head. Can we conclude this saying that the bull that he's standing on is Vishnu? When the chariot trampled, when the axle broke and chariot started sliding down, Vishnu came to rescue that in the form of a bull, Malvide, which we saw it earlier. And that Vishnu was standing there. Accidentally, Shiva has placed his one leg on top of that. Or just to say, Shiva was helped by Vishnu also as bull in doing the Tripura Samhara is represented here in the sculptural form at the Tiruvaliswaram temple. A very, very unique and beautiful sculpture, not found anywhere in this country. This is again Triprasamhara Murthy with this concept, Triprasundari, from the Koshta images of the Gopura of the Chidambaram temple. Look at the beauty of that. Triprasamhara Murthy there. A fine sculptural representation with all the ornamentation. It looks like more like a bronze image. The Ellora. The Kailasha temple of Ellora. The Rashtrakuta creations. What a beautiful Triprasamhara Murthy. Exactly beautiful. The entire story has been explained in this wonderful sculpture. Shiva standing there, which we saw that earlier, how he is represented very beautifully in this. Look at that. In the same temple of Ellora, on the outer Prakara wall, you have again a Triprasamhara Murthy, which is shown very beautiful, standing on top of the chariot and doing the Samhara. The Brahma is seen there as the charioteer. And look at that expression on the face of Shiva. Look at the Raudram, the eyes, the smile in the face, the lips. What a combination, Raudram and smile. Which is very unique of Shiva in Astraprantaka. The two emotions are beautifully shown here in this sculpture of the Rashtrakutas at the Kailashnatha temple at Ellora. What an expression. This is again a beautiful representation of Triprantaka from the Ramappa temple built by the Kakatiyas. What a beautiful representation of Shiva. This is on the lintel of the temple. A beautiful representation in granite, polished granite. What an amazing sculpture it is. You see all the devatas, Vishnu by one side, Brahma on the other side, so many other, the Ganesha, Subramanya, and Parvati, everybody are there around this. What a beautiful representation of this form of Triprantaka. Look at the close-up. How Triprantaka is standing. I mean, see, it's in a position on the top of the chariot. Brahma is seen as a charioteer. Look at the way with the folded legs he's there, blessing and also holding the bow and arrow there. What a beautiful representation of Triprantaka. This is the famous mural painting of the Rajaraja period, located in the Sandara, that the inner corridor of the Prakara of the temple of Prakadishwara at Tanjavur, done about 1,000 years ago. What a beautiful representation of Shiva there. Shiva is seen top of the chariot holding the bow on the left and the action on the right, removing the arrow from his holder. What a beautiful representation with multiple arms. All the devatas and devas are seen around him in their different mounts. Brahma is seen here as the charioteer. Here you have Bhadrakali, Durga, Ganesha, and Subramanya all going around there. Down below you see Vishnu's in the form of the bull there, supporting the chariot also. What a beautiful painting. This painting alone can be spoken about for almost 1 hour. That's so much of greatness in this beautiful painting. And this is the best representation of Triprantaka form of painting that is as early as 1,000 years ago. This is the close-up view of the Triprantaka's face. Look at the beauty of the Triprantaka's face there. The bulging red eyes, twisted eyebrows, and the smile on his face. Clearly observe the three eyes. The two eyes are bulging out. The eyebrows are twisted, showing the anger. but down below his lips are smiling. How could he bring the two emotions together in one face? What an artistic creation that is seen there. Amazing representation of Triprantaka done 1,000 years ago in the temple of Rajaraja. Who's the great artist who did it? God alone knows. What a beautiful representation. My salutations to them. What a beautiful representation, again, from the Vijayanagar period in the Hampi temple of Virupaksha. What a beautiful representation of Triprantaka. You can see there, the 17th century Vijayanagar. Here, it's wonderfully depicted. Shiva is seen there standing on top of the chariot. Brahma is seen riding the chariot with the four horses. The three asuras and the three forts are seen here. And look at the Mount Meru has become the bow, and the Vasuki, the snake, becomes the string for this. And above all, the importance is here. Vishnu is seen as the arrow. The image of Vishnu is here. The Agni, the Yama, all are seen here. What a beautiful representation of this amazing painting of the Vijayanagar period in the Virupaksha temple of 17th century at Hampi. Triprantaka is one of the most elegant forms of Shiva that captures your eyes and mind. More so in the bronze images sanctified in our temples spread across the Tamil country. Today, it's rare to see these wonderful bronzes in our temples. They are either confined to small corners of the temple or damaged or put into the cellar rooms or given away for safe custody to the government. We do not know where they are. Most of these images are now seen only in the museums around the world or in the private collections of the great people. This is the beautiful Koneri Rajapuram. I told you, look at the way the dress has been done for the Umadevi. And this, luckily this time we saw a good dress on Shiva. Earlier times when I had seen it was a dirty dress. Look at the chandan that is there on the top of the forehead. It's never been removed. This form of Shiva of Triprantaka, who won over the evil with his gentle smile and took the majestic form to save the world from Maya. My pranams to this captivating Triprantaka and the wonderful form of Triprantaka brought out by the unknown Stapatis and who created them in sculpture and in bronze images. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. If you have any questions, I'm prepared to take.
Thank you, Guru. I have a question.
Yes, sir.
After listening to you now, I've always assumed that, till now, I've assumed that Jagasamhara Murti was your favorite. But now it appears that you have to choose between Triprantaka and Gajasamhara Murti. And tell
it's
us
not. Which,
only one. You are allowed only one pick.
It's because, not so. Shiva is my favorite. Shiva in any form is very admirable for me.
No, that was on the lighter side, but it's amazing because I think the overview, the tip of the iceberg of what you gave us today in itself is probably, it evidences everything that you could do a doctoral thesis just on Triprantaka. So it's wonderful. Anyway, you're welcome to answer the question.